In this tutorial, we're going to see how to get started with Unity's new shader graph. We will learn how to install a lightweight renderer pipeline and shader graph packages, create a new shader, we'll learn about the shader graph basics, and create a material of the shader and assign it to a game object. With Unity 2019.1, the lightweight render pipeline is released and ready for production, so is the shader graph. So make sure you're using at least Unity 2019.1. Go to the Window tab and click Package Manager. Make sure you're reviewing all packages, and in the search bar, type Light. And click Install. Now let's install shader graph. In the search bar, search for shader, click the shader graph and click install. Now we need to create the lightweight render pipeline asset. In the project tab, click the right mouse button, select create, rendering, lightweight render pipeline, pipeline asset. Next, we need to set this render pipeline asset as the render pipeline asset to be used for rendering. Go to the edit tab in the main menu. Select Project Setting, and in the Graphics tab, drag the asset you created to the Scriptable Render Pipeline Setting input box. And now we can start with the shader graph. Just to be neat and clean, I'll open a folder named Shaders. Click the right mouse button, select Create, Shader, and we have three options to select from. PBR graph, which is physically based rendering, subgraph, and unlit graph. For this demonstration, I'll select the PBR graph, and I'll name it First Shader. Double click to open the graph. Every shader has a master node. Physically based rendering shader has a PBR master node. The most common inputs are albedo. Albedo is the base color, commonly known as a diffuse map. Normal, also known as normal map or bump map, can be used to create bumps, grooves, scratches, and other imperfections on the surface. Emission can make your object glow. Metallic node enables you to select the material to be either metallic or non-metallic. And smoothness, control how light bounces off the material. This is the main preview. It shows you how the material is rendered. You can resize it using the little minus icon in the right bottom. And by right-clicking, you can select another mesh to be skinned with your shader. Using the mouse wheel, you can zoom in and zoom out. Let's play around with some inputs and see what we can do. First, the albedo. Right-click or press the space bar and select Create Node. Type Color and select the Color option. You can drag the node, click the color bar, and select the color. Click the output and drag it to the albedo input and the master. And check the change on the main preview. Next, the normal input. For this, I'm going to bring a normal map or a bump map image. By dragging the image from the project into the shader graph, we automatically create a sample texture 2D node with the image as a texture. On the left side of the node, we have inputs that can manipulate the output of this node, and on the right side, we have the different outputs this node can provide. This node provides four outputs, one RGBA, red, green, blue, and alpha, and one node for red, green, blue, and alpha separately. We'll drag the RGBA output to the normal input on the master. Our selected normal map emulates a brick wall, and we can see the change on the main preview. You can delete the connection by clicking on the connection line and pressing delete. By selecting a color for the emission, we make the material glow. By selecting a black color, it makes it unglowy. Now let's change the metallic from 0 non-metallic to 1 metallic. And change the preview to show a sphere, so the changes will be more apparent. Now let's change the smoothness from 0, a rough surface that scatters and reflects light in a blurry way, to a very smooth surface that deflects light very sharply. You are good by selecting any number between 0 and 1. Don't forget to save the shader. Let's close the shader graph window and put our shader on some meshes. Right click on the hierarchy tab, select 3D object, sphere. Click the sphere so we can see its components in the inspector panel. We can drag the shader directly into the inspector, but you probably want to create a material for the shader first. Right click on the shader, select Create Material. We'll name it First Shader Mat and drag the material on the sphere's components. Now let's see how we can change properties of the shader outside of the shader graph window. Double click the shader. On the top left side, we have the blackboard where we can add properties that we can tweak outside of the graph. Click the plus button on the blackboard and you can see the different types of inputs we can use as properties. Let's make our albedo color a property we can tweak from outside the graph. Right click the color node and select convert to property. As you can see, it's been added to the blackboard. Double click the name to change the name of the property. Save the asset. Select the sphere and in the inspector, open the options of the shader. From there, you can see we have a new main color, which we can change. And see the changes live in our scene. Let's duplicate our sphere game object with the material. And as you can see, if we change the main color of one of them, we changes the color of everyone because we're changing the same material instance. If we want different colors using the same shader, the easiest and most basic way to do it is to create another material from the same shader. We can add more properties to the shader, like a vector 1 for controlling the metallic. You can use the property by dragging it from the blackboard, or by right clicking, selecting Create Node, and then selecting it from the menu called Properties. Don't forget to save the shader. Tell me if you found this tutorial helpful and please check my other tutorials and videos in my channel. You'll find a diverse content that might help you as a developer. See you in the next video.